Welcome back. England was a place that prided itself on tradition, and one of the linchpins of the week was Sunday lunch. Amani Zain went to a Yemeni version in Yorkshire.
I've come up north to meet the Yemeni community living there, and I found out that they have a Yorkshire welcome with a difference.
So did you have quite a good night last night?
Oh yeah, of course. So I've been chewing until about 1 o'clock.
You know, me and Mohammed, we swing maybe 6 days, five days a week.
Oh, so you're quite hardcore then? Yeah. You kind of like it, but not. When did you start chewing?
Basically, there is a different tradition in Yemen between the cities. But in my country, it's in a village. And it's, you know, you don't have to chew after when you are 21 years old because it's very expensive and you have to work to get some money.
Where are you from?
It's in Yafa.
Yafa, okay. Yeah.
Fatih's Cafe is a popular Yemeni restaurant in Sheffield, serving lots of traditional Yemeni food. It's also a hotspot for Yemenis. I met some guys there who had some very strong opinions on qat.
Yeah, I think it is addicted because, I mean, I think the only reason why I disagree with it is because as kids, when we were young kids, there was like six of us and young kids, and my dad was just on it all the time. Whenever he didn't have qat, he was the most horriblest man I've ever met. He was so horrible to us, to his parents. As soon as he had qat, it changed him. He was happy, he danced.
But do you not think that's more about people's personalities?
Yeah, it's giving them a personality disorder as well, because it's like they can't function without it after a while.
Like for young people to chew once a week within moderation, I don't think it's that bad.
He will give them credit, get them in debt, and it is just like drugs.
It's just the same.
If someone comes to buy cards off you, they haven't got money. You give them credit.
I get this.
You give them credit. So it's, you know, to me it's no different.
We are happy with that. We are happy.
Yeah, but okay, I'm happy.
Because we don't drink alcohol.
Yeah, but of
we are Muslims. You know, that God is different than the alcohol.
Yeah.
We don't like that alcohol. The Muslim people like that God is chewing together, talk about Yemen. And Islam and Arab.
Well, what do you think about he saying that it's addictive?
No, you don't like that drink. That guy. You like maybe you like drink. I love that guy. I like
what she's saying.
I'm 15 years now.
What she's saying is, I'm saying I don't like that. I'm saying it makes our people very lazy. In business, they don't want to do no. They want to sit and chew car. That's what I'm saying.
They don't ban it.
No. Okay, I think we're going to go now because we've started a big debate.
That evening, I was invited to a qat party myself.
Got my green gold in my hand, so I'm well prepared.
For a Saturday night qat tune, there's a certain etiquette that one must follow. Step one, prepare a good meal before the tune.
This is the meat mixed with the onions, with the spice, with the salt, yogurt, all this marinated overnight and left out here. So now we're going to boil the rice and we're going to put it on the top.
Step two, dress to impress. Step three, prepare the necessary non-alcoholic beverages for your guests. Step four, prepare the green gold. Half-fill vase with cold water, place qat in water and watch your bud bloom. And step five, sit back, relax and let the conversation flow.
Do you think chewing qat is important to family life?
I wouldn't say important, but it's part of our culture.
We always do it together, sometimes the men and their own.
Do you look forward to it? I mean, do you enjoy it?
I enjoy it better when I'm sitting with my family. You know, we talk about everything, we plan things.
So it would be a shame if they banned it in the UK then?
Oh yeah. So because then that's it, we've got nothing to do.
Ibrahim's your dad.
Yes, that's right.
Do you sit and chew together?
Yeah, we do.
And what do you like about it? I mean, you're kind of, you're a young guy, lots of temptations out there, going out, dancing.
Well, the truth is, at the end of the day, it brings me closer to my dad.
Okay.
It brings me a lot closer to my family. I mean, I could go out, yeah, I could do all these kind of things that it's possible to be doing, but I'd rather be home with my family. And if it means that we can sit down and relax, chub as a cat, I'm happy with that. That's enough for me.
Sit, I mean, gathering with all the people and the friends you know well, it just really reminds you exactly the way we are back home in Yemen. Yeah. Yes, I mean, we're all surrounded by our family, brothers, sisters, nephews, nieces, and it's exactly the same. This is what we miss in England. And everybody who's in all over the world, especially in European country, they do miss this. Yes.
Someone who uses Qat as a creative tool is Yasser, local shopkeeper by day, oud player by night.
عصفور الشجر يوم ما يرجع.
Yasser has convinced me to try some qat, so here goes. I'll try a little bit. How old were you when you first started chewing?
I'd say about 15, 16.
15?
Yeah.
Yep, so yep. So you pick the little bits off like that, and these are the bits that you chew?
No, you only just chew that from the, with the whole of the stem.
Oh, so you chew all of that?
Yeah.
Right, okay. Here it goes.
What do you think?
It's quite... What does it taste like? It does taste very bitter, doesn't it?
It is bitter.
I mean, it's just, it's, I would say it's quite sharp and tangy, rather than like, not horrible, but I can't, there's nothing, you know, nothing I can describe
it to.
I don't
know, I wouldn't be able to describe the actual taste of that.
And then this is what you do, so you'd keep breaking little bits off.
Little bits off.
And then storing it in your cheek.
That's right.
Do you always play your music when you chew?
Most of the time. At least a song or two.
And do you think that it helps you kind of be a bit more creative?
Yeah,
chewing?
Yeah, I'd say so, yeah, it definitely does. It just puts you into the right mood to be singing and enjoying yourself. And
I mean, do you look forward to like Saturday evening getting together for a
qat? I think I'd say 99.5% of the Yemenis in Sheffield look forward to Saturday evening.
Well, there you have it. Everyone that I've met says it's part of our heritage, culture and tradition, and it's true. I personally don't have a problem with it, within moderation. But with anything, if it's taken in excess and causes you to neglect your family, work and responsibilities, that can't be good. But the same can be said for having too much chocolate or television. I think I'm going to go and join my new friends for a qat, hear some stories of the old countries, and maybe build some castles in the sky.
Like tea for the English and wine for the French, qat is an integral part of Yemeni culture. We'll see how long the British government agrees. That's it for now, but do join me next time for another edition of Witness.